when I was sleeping on the train, sleeping on Mesero Lab out in the rain, without even a single slice of pizza to my name. Too proud to beg for change, mastering the pain, when New York niggas was calling southern rappers lame. But then Jack and I slang, I used to get dizzy spells, hear a little rain.
Yo, what's good? Today I'm going to give an extensive breakdown on where our presidents are selected and not elected, considering the fact that we live in a monarchy system that's predicated upon democracy, which is the precursor to a totalitarian communistic agenda that engineers a hedonistic society through Satanism. But first, I'm going to give a complete synopsis on why your motherfucking vote don't even matter in the first place, especially if you classify yourself as black. So with that being said, I need every black person on the planet to get a Black's Law Dictionary 1 through 5 edition and understand the terminology intuitively, because when you study the codes of Sycamore 2s, it states verbatim that if you classify yourself as black, African American, Negro, or color, that you do not have rights in the United States government because you are property. Because everybody knows that America is not a country, it's a corporation that systematically capitalizes off black people, which is why we only own 3.8% of the world's wealth. But you also have to understand the ideology behind it, because when you look at it from a voting standpoint, this autonomous monetary system is not going to let you vote them out of legislation, because they capitalize off you, because you are property. So with all that being said, I'm going to give you a visual aid. I'm going to give a document, a government document, that basically specifies everything I just fucking said to your ass. Now, it is also very imperative for you to understand that when you look at the Naturalization Act, it also specifies that only white people are allowed to be citizens in this country. So I need black people to understand etymology and linguistics intuitively, so they can beat around the semantics that's being played in government. Because when you look at the word United States of America, that little bitty word of denotes ownership. Not ownership of white people, not ownership of Mexican people, not ownership of any other type of people on the planet, only ownership of black people, because we don't have a nationality. When you don't have a nationality, you don't have a pedigree on this geographical landmass to where you get restitution and reparations, and to where you can reap the benefits of the shit that you actually deserve on this planet, because we predate everything. We've been here first before everybody. When you look at the dictionaries that started out in 1828, when you look up the word American citizen, they said that this geographical landmass belonged to a copper-colored people. Last time I checked, the only people whose skin look copper is mine. And I'm a pretty dark type of dude, you know what I'm saying? But I'm pretty sure you understand where I'm coming from. So what it all comes down to, it comes down to the fact that black people have to be, we have to tap into some type of edification to where we can get the truth and galvanize our resources and bring them to the table. Because you got to look up, you got to do research, you got to be a motherfucking detective if you want the truth. I mean, you got to look up the Rex 84 plan, look at the Black Messiah Act, look at the G3526 strong concordance that correlates with the Black Christian codes through the Inquisition, look at Title 12, Section 411. The information is out there. So we have to start doing our research to where, you know what I'm saying, we can, you know, reap the benefits of the shit that we actually deserve in this country. Now let's look at it from a Darwinism evolution theory perspective. When you understand that this primitive tyrannical government propagates racism through the evolution theory, which coincides with the US Constitution by saying that black people are 3/5 of white people, meaning that we're a subhuman. So when they shoot us down in the streets by racist cops and shit like that, it is being rectified and justified, considering the fact that they believe that we are animals and that we are subhuman like cattle. So this is why the vast majority of black people like Breonna Taylor, we don't, you know what I'm saying, we haven't got any type of justice in this country, because like I said, it is propagated through the evolution theory and through the U.S. Constitutions. That's where the 3/5 of a man ideology came from. And I'm going to give you a visual aid on that right now. Now, so with all that shit being said, your motherfucking vote don't even matter because you are considered as property because you don't have any rights. So stop wanting to be validated by a system that doesn't give a fuck about you in the first place. Now we're going to get off into the fact that government and politics and religion go hand in hand. Because when you look at the word democracy and break down the etymological roots of it, it means demonic rulership. Demo comes from the word demon, and Chrissy, C-R-A-C-Y, comes from the Greek god Kratos, which is Kronos, who is the god of Saturn. Saturn is etymological roots, comes from the word Satan. So every monotheistic religion on the planet that is connected to Freemasonry also worships Satan. So that's what it comes down to. You got to get this book right here. It'll break down. This is the unlock the whole goddamn Da Vinci Code for you. Because it talks about sacred geometry, grumic magic, Freemasonry. So, you know, the science of symbolism and things of that nature. But it's called The Secret Ages of All Teachings by Manly P. Hall. He was a 33rd degree Mason. And this book is also in the CIA library. So, like I said, this is a legitimate source of information right here. But so with that being said, so you got the understanding of what a demonic rulership, a democracy is. So the vast majority of these eugenics programs that relinquish your rights and tries to eradicate humanity through biological and psychological warfare and through the prison industrial complex, all these agendas come from the Democratic Party. So you can kind of understand why these Freemasonic deep state Democrats wanted to recruit Kamala Harris, bitch ass. She's out here locking niggas up, you know what I'm saying, for weed charges. And she let niggas go with pedophile charges. Like, that don't even make sense to me. So, for those who do not believe that these motherfuckers worship Satan and how it's interchangeable with monotheistic religion, but they telling you to worship God, but they God is actually Satan. And I'm going to show you in a clip on how it was at a government meeting. It's a 1 minute clip. They was at a government meeting, and at the end of the prayer or the seance or whatever, the bitch said, "Hail Satan." I'm not even joking. So that is, you know what I'm saying? And these are chief justices in the Supreme Courts, you know what I'm saying, doing this shit at government meetings and shit like that. And also understand that the vast majority of chief justices in the United States of America are Jewish people. And then, like I said, if you know anything about, you know what I'm saying, the Jewish community, they said the synagogues of Satan are people who worship God in a synagogue. And only people who do that are the Jews.
Be present in this moment. Clear our minds and be free of outdated propaganda and regulations that were created by historical people who were afraid of the unknown. Let us embrace the impulse to eat of the tree of knowledge of good and evil so that we may let go of comforting delusions and see the truth in the world. Let us demand that humans be judged for their actions, not their loyalty to useless social norms, labels, and categories. Let us stand firm against all authority that tries to threaten the unalienable rights of all humans. Let us cast aside our differences to use reason, logic, science, and compassion to create solutions for the greater good of our community. It is done. Hail Satan. Thank you.
Yeah, y'all thought I was lying. That bitch said hail Satan at the end. But what it comes down to in conclusion is that, you know, we have to galvanize our resources to revitalize and recalibrate our sovereignty on this planet by getting nationalized. So if you want, you know, justice in this country and to basically navigate through this fictitious system that we call America, we have to, you know, get nationalized. But like, comment, subscribe, all that shit, follow my pages or whatever. This is my first YouTube video, so please, you know, have some type of support me in some type of way. Share it all over the place. Get this information out there, because we still have black people out here really thinking that we're actually free in this country when the system is basically set up for us to, you know, basically fail.
didn't have no straps, you couldn't wear your necklace. Niggas hand around your throat, that's a choker reference. My ancestors took old food, made soul food. Jim Crow's a troll too, he stole the soul music. That's the blood that goes through me, so if you assuming I could never sell my soul, they sold it soul to me. Peaceful teaching the roommate, but don't confuse me. You mouth off for the cameras, I make a silent movie. Now here's some jury. No civilization is conquered from the outside until it destroys itself from within. Pin. Put a pin in that, we'll come back when I fin. You can't talk like I talk, cause you ain't been well.